First and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahawah Wa Hashem, Yahawashi, Wa Hashem, Yahawah Kadash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahawah, and His Son's name is Yahawashi. Okay? And honors to the elder apostles of great wisdom that taught me this truth, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning across the globe in the hopes of being saved within these last days. This lesson is going to be called, "And Yahawah Yahawashi, the Most High, shall send them strong delusions that they shall believe a lie." A lot of our people, they've been sent strong delusions. Okay? So we're going to get into this, and Lord willing, this is edifying. Okay? Really, I should have done this video a couple days ago, but I had other things in work. It's all according to the Spirit. Okay? Okay. So we're going to start on Thessalonians. Let's start at Thessalonians chapter 2 and 8. "And then shall that wicked be revealed," okay, Esau, "and the wicked of our own people," but predominantly Esau, "whom the Lord Yahushua shall consume with the spirit of his mouth." So this word, what is it doing? It's consuming the wicked, okay, with the spirit of his mouth, which is this word, "and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming," okay, "even him whose coming is after the working of Satan." So a lot of men, their coming is after the work of what? Working of Satan. On the left hand side, "with all power." Yeah, Satan has particular power that was given to him by the Heavenly Father. "And signs." So Satan's able to do signs and lying wonders. Right? And this is through Esau's what? Technology. The so-called science. Right? "And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth." So a lot of our people, they're going to perish because they didn't receive the love of the truth. Why? Because they were deceived. And that's why Esau pushes out these different philosophies, these wayward philosophies, to keep you lost, to keep you away from the scriptures. Okay? And that's why it says, "because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved." Verse 11, "And for this cause, the Most High shall send them strong delusions." So if they were not receiving, if they were deceiving, they were not receiving the love of the truth. That means Yahawah gave them what? Sent them strong delusion. Strong. That they should believe a lie. That's why you've got individuals, they may come into, they may hear this truth, and they may have the mentality, well, they're looking at the truth like the truth is a hindrance, like it's not true. Like this is holding them back. Like there has to be more to this. No, this is the truth. Okay? But they shall be what? Strong delusions. They're going to believe in their own lies. When you go into that word delusion, it's the act of misleading someone. So someone that's been delusional, someone that's delusional, they're going to be what? Deceiving. Act of misleading someone, deception, deceit, delusionum, from Latin disillunum. Let's further go into this word. A psychology and an erroneous belief that is held in the face of evidence to the contrary, which is basically psychotic. That's what it actually means to be psychotic. So if you're delusional, yes, you're psychotic. Okay? A mistaken or unfounded opinion or an idea. Right? An act of deluding, deception by creating illusionary ideas. Okay? And that's why the scripture says the deceived and the deceiver are his. Illusion is the impression that though false is entertained originally on the recommended of the senses or the imagination, but awaits full acceptance and may not influence action. Delusion, and they call it delusions of grandeur. Right? A false impression or belief of a fixed nature. It all goes into what? Misleading. Those that are delusional, what? They're going to be misleading. They're not just misled. They're going to be misleading others. Verse 12, that they all might be damned who believe not the truth. And damned goes into what? Condemned. Who believe not the truth. But had pleasure right? So you're going to get some that claim to be in the truth, but the Lord has sent them strong delusions, and they're damned because they believe not the truth, but have pleasure in all unrighteousness. Okay? And I want to get this. That's why, again, humility, and that's why we've got to count it a blessing that we know the truth. Don't boast, got to count it a blessing. Okay? Let's go to 2 Corinthians 4 and 4. Get this in the right order. 2 Corinthians 4. And again, start at 4. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry as we have not received, as we have received mercy, okay, through this ministry, we faith not, okay, we don't get weak and go back into the world, but have renounced. Renounce means to make known. We have hidden things, which is deceit, of dishonesty, because you have men that come to this, they're very dishonest, not walking in craftiness, right? Nor handling the word of the Lord deceitfully, the word of Yahweh deceitfully. See, you've got to remember what we're dealing with is very, very, very serious. So you don't want to be handling this word deceitfully in any way or form or fashion. But by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of the Most High. But if our gospel be hid, this gospel, this word, is hid. It is hid to them that are lost. Right? So yes, Yahawah has hid this word for to them that are lost. Right? In whom the power of this world, it says the God of this world. And who's the God of this world? Right now at this moment of time, Satan. Okay? You've got the spiritual demon Satan and his counterpart, which is Esau, have blinded the minds of them which believe not. So it's really Esau that has done that, blinded their minds. And he does this by what? Pushing out all false ideologies, false religions, ways of life, to blind our people. And to demonize, Esau's whole thing is to demonize the scriptures, because it condemns him. And that's why you have Christians that will say, I don't believe in the Bible, but hold on, aren't you a so-called Christian? No, it's because Esau put it in your mind not to believe in the Bible. He taught you his way. That's the light of the glorious gospel. I'm not sure if you have the image of the Most High should shine unto them. Because if they did believe in it, they wouldn't be blinded. For we preach not ourselves, but must we act to have the Lord and ourselves, your servants, for must we act safe. Right? So bear with just a minute. So this word, not all of our people are going to get in. Of course it does. When you first wake up the truth, of course it upsets you, but over time, you get over it. You know, when you first hear about the truth, it's like, why can't they get it? You know, I see it clear. Why can't they get it? Go to Romans 10. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to the Most High for Israel is that they might be saved. So even Paul was praying that all Israel might be saved, for I bear them record, witness that they have a zeal. Yeah, our people have a zeal. Okay. They may believe in some type of higher force, but they don't have it, but not according to knowledge. In other words, it's an ignorant zeal. It's not according to the truth of the scriptures. It's according to their opinion or what they feel or their perception. For they being ignorant of the Most High's righteousness. And that word ignorant goes into idiotas. Idiotas. To not know. And going about to establish their own righteousness. And this scripture right here, it fits Christians heavily. Because if you're ignorant to the Lord Yahweh's will and what he likes and what he don't like, you're gonna what form your own righteousness. And you're gonna think that's when it's not. And have not submitted. See, this is about submitting themselves unto the righteousness of the Most High. Right? For Mashiach is the end of the law, for righteousness to everyone that believeth. Right? So Paul said, not all of our people are going to get this truth. Okay? And you can't really, you can't get too upset. We pray, when we're out here, we want our people to get it. This is what I'm saying. That's that compassion. We want our people to get it, but not all our people gonna get this. Go to Proverbs 20:4. The hearing ear, if you can hear, and seeing eye, the Lord Yahawah has made even both of them. So if He's made both of them, He controls who hears and who don't hear, who sees and who don't see. That's why you got to count it a blessing. That's why we've got to count it a blessing and stay as humble as possible. Alright, we've got that as well. Should we go to Psalms? And we've got Daniel's journey just a minute. So before we go to that, let's go to... You bear me just a minute. Do one thing at a time. Particular scripture I'm looking for, but it's not coming up. Bear me just a minute. This always happens. Let's see if I can find it. That's why it's a blessing. Don't think if this is a light thing. To know what you know, even if it's just one or two or three scriptures. Don't have the mindset, well, I wish I knew what he knew. Well, the Lord Yahawah woke you up. Alright, it's Daniel 12 and 10. Okay. Before we go to that, let's go to Matthew's 13 and 10, I believe it is. You could be teaching this word an hour to someone. If they're not supposed to get it, they're not going to get it. You speak to them, you're blue in the face. If they're not supposed to get it, they're not going to get it. Go to Matthew 13 and we're going to go straight to 11. Start at 10. And the disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou unto them in parables? Parables is a dark saying. Okay. So Yahawah was speaking in parables. Okay. In riddles. Okay. In dark sayings. Dark sentences. He answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven. Right? So again, how shall I reply to the disciples? It's given unto you. Right? Because they knew their eyes were open, their ears were open. Right? And to the rest that were not supposed to get it, they were not going to get it. There would be times where Yahawah would expound on particular things, so okay, when the disciples would not get it. But to them it is not given. So Yahawah said, them it's not given to the rest. Given to you. 1:12. For whosoever hath to him shall be given. Right? So who really has is going to be given, understands, going to be given more. And he shall have more abundance. Right? So you have just going to increase you with the wisdom, with the understanding you already have. And that's why the scriptures also say, with all that wisdom, get understanding. But that understanding needs to be given to you by Yahawah. But whosoever have not from him shall be taken away, even that he have. Therefore I speak to them in parables. Right? And Yahawah speaking to his disciples and the rest of the followers in parables, that was his stumbling block to the rest that were not supposed to get it. That was that separation. Along with the faith, because with the faith, you're given faith. You're going to be able to understand, because they seeing not, seeing see not. So our people see, but they see not. They see the sign, but they're still guessing. And hearing, they hear not. People hear the words, but it still doesn't resonate. It goes in one ear and right out the other. Neither do they understand. Okay, which is perceived, and in them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah, which is Isaiah. It saith, by hearing ye shall hear, and shall not understand. Okay? So our people hear, but it's like they don't, it just goes in one ear and out the other. And seeing we shall see and shall not perceive. You've got the signs and people are still guessing. But this people's heart is wax gross. We're going to that word wax. Gross clearly just I missed that word as well when God's mystery came to me. I want to quickly go to that word mystery as well. When you go to that word mystery, select it.
Mysterion.
So when you go into that word mystery, it's a hidden or secret thing. Generally mystery. Confided only to the initiated, not only to ordinary mortals. So those that were initiated, they were initiated through what? The Spirit, the Holy Spirit, they were initiated by that. Not by a group, they were initiated through the Holy Spirit, through Yahawashi. And not to ordinary mortals. A hidden or secret thing, not obvious to the understanding. So it's supposed to be hidden, and it's not supposed to be obvious to the world, the hidden purpose of counsels. So Yahawashi is hidden particular purpose and counsels from what? The world. Secret will of men, of the Most High, the secret counsels which govern the Most High in dealing with the righteous. You see, which are hidden from the ungodly. So it says these things are hidden from the ungodly. And wicked men but claim to the godly. And that's why again count it a blessing, because we go off. But it still says these things are given to the godly. So if you know these things, because you were considered godly. But it says hidden from the ungodly and wicked men but claim to the godly. And that's why our people get into witchcraft and trying to divine. You would only need to do that because Yahawah has not given you the mystery. Because the prophets are the ones that reveal what the secret, or image or vision, or seen in a vision. So we're done with that. So we want to go back to the prophecy of Isaiah, that shall understand the seeing shall see and shall not perceive. But this people's heart is not scrolled, so you bear with me just a minute. You go with that word wax. Wax gross. Okay, we're going to type in that word wax gross. Pakono. Pakono. And it says to make fit. And I'll say to make fat. So they be made fit, fat, dumb, slow. That word retard means slow. Metaphor, to make stupid. To render to the soul dull or callous. And again, this ain't personal, I'm just reading what the scriptures are saying. To stupefy. So when someone's just scratching their head and they can't understand this word, okay, they may be holding their chin, arms crossed, it's because the Lord locked them out, he doesn't want them to get it. And you may ask me, well, why would the Lord create a people and not want them to understand? So we could be more so justified in destroying them. And there is dal of hearing. So when you go into the word dal,
Barreos.
So that is dal, means heavy, heavily, with difficulty. Okay. And it's an angel that has done this. And their eyes, they have closed, so their eyes have been closed. But their eyes are open, their physical eyes, but their eyes are actually closed spiritually, in a spiritual sense. They cannot see. There's any time they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, they should understand. So Yahawah doesn't want all of our people to understand. And if our people don't understand, there's a particular spirit they're going to have. It's going to be a spirit of envy, scoffing, because people, they're angry, they speak wicked of what they don't understand as natural brute beasts. Okay? They should understand with their heart and should be converted. So if they were to understand, that's how that conversion comes. So the brothers that have woken up to this truth, they've been converted because Yahawah has given up that spirit to understand, to worship the true power, to call to return, to bring back to the love of obedience and mashup, to the love for the children, to the wisdom and righteousness, to turn oneself. This is what you need to go into words. And I should fill them. And that's where that healing comes. The first you need to be given a faith. Okay? To make whole, to cure, to free from errors and sins, and to bring one salvation. But blessed are your eyes, those that have been woken up, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. For verily I say unto you that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which ye see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which ye hear and have not heard them. Because at that particular time they were prophesying of particular things, but they have seen them, because all these prophets, most of the prophets, are back here again today. Okay? So now we're going to go into Daniel's, it's all linking up, Daniel's 12 and 10. Right? Daniel's 10 and 12, 12 and 10. Let's go to 9. And he said, go that way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed to the time of the end. Okay, that's when Yahawah came on the scene. Okay. Many shall be purified and made white, which is pure, clean, and tried, tested. Okay, and that's referring to the hopeful elect. But the wicked shall do wickedly. Okay, but the wicked were going to do wickedly of our own nation, and none of the wicked shall understand. And you know, when we went into that word mysteries, it says that are hidden, the mysteries are hidden from the ungodly, from the wicked, but given to what? The godly. And none of the wicked shall understand. Okay, but the wise shall understand. Okay, and how are they made wise? How are they made wise? Through Yahawah Shai. Through them being opened up to the truth. Okay? So yeah, you're gonna get that when you first come in. You really get upset. Because you're really compassionate. You want your people to get it, but not all of our people are gonna get it. So that's where, again, more humility comes into play. Knowing these things, not boasting. Okay? It was a gift. If Yahawah Shai gave you that gift to believe, to have faith, hold on to that gift. Because many the desire to know what you know. Many people, you've got millions of people on this earth looking for answers, looking for the truth. And you have it. Don't take this truth for granted. Until the next time, Shalom.